When I walk out to the middle, the only thing on my mind is to help the team. But sometimes, it just doesn't go the way you want it to.
Oh, edged and taken!
They're all around him. And he's taken it! He's got the hat trick!
Most importantly, when you get knocked down, just remember, the only way for you to go is up.
Ouch.
It just takes the slightest bit of confidence, and you're back.
That's a nice shot.
Yes.
Very good.
Yes, wait for the wider blip. This is the depth of the crease.
Yeah.
Wonderful. But moment, the problem. For.
That's a half century for Joshua Da Silva, his second in Test match cricket. What the West Indies have found is a wicketkeeper who's coming in and giving them valuable runs.
What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. And before I get into what it's about, I don't even remember how to make videos. It's been that long. And I apologize once again, but we're back. We're getting, check out the shirt. Look at it. JDS, Trusty Process. My girlfriend made me this. Look at it back. It's a shark. Let me know if y'all want some GDS shirts. We can get back some hats. We get some merch going. Let me know in the comments down below. But yeah, today we're gonna get into the mental side of cricket. So before you saw in the intro, the downs and then the ups and then the downs. It's all part of parcel of cricket in general, not just Test cricket. You can see up here, I have Trust the Process, and it's such a broad term that can be used for anything. We're just gonna change one word in that, and we're gonna make it Trust Your Process. For you, it makes it more individual. It makes it more close to your heart. You're trusting what you are doing, because everybody has a different process. Not everybody goes through the same opportunities. Not everybody goes through the same training program. Not everybody's the same. That's the moral of what I'm trying to say. So to get into this and what we want to achieve by exposing the mental side of cricket, it just shows that is one of the most, if not the most important side of the game. Growing up in school cricket, my coach used to always tell me 90% mental. And it's true when they say you fail more than you succeed. It's a brutal game, but we love it. Why do we love it? Because the rewards are so sweet. The feeling of scoring 100, or the feeling of taking 5 wickets. And honestly, like, it's probably the best thing I would take in the world. There's no greater feeling than scoring 100 or taking the winning catch, or just being that game-changing moment. Today we're looking at Trust Your Process. I want to thank John O'Hurst for this. After my Test debut, he surprised me with that. So Joshua Da Silva Test debut, New Zealand versus West Indies at Wellington, December 10th to 13th, 2020. Could you believe it's been over a year since I made my Test debut? I don't have words still. It's been over a year and I still can't explain that feeling of Test cricket. But if you haven't seen the documentary, I'll leave it linked up somewhere there. You can take a look at it. Getting into the video and the topic of the video today, the mental side of cricket, it's definitely challenging mentally when you're not scoring runs. Now definitely I'm in a much greater place, a much better mindset, thanks to Monty and my parents and a lot of people around me. All my close friends have helped me through it, my siblings, everyone. I'm grateful, very grateful for Monty, and he's definitely helped me tremendously in the mental side of things. Just doing simple things like reading a book. I've only started reading because of him. I saw him reading a book. I was like, Mons, can I take a read? And then after that, he gifted me the book at the end of the Bangladesh series. So that was Think Like a Monk, and now I'm on to MetaHuman. So it's just something that you train yourself to do. I'm not a reader, definitely not. I hate reading. I hated anything to do with books, but it helped me a lot with patience. There are times you're gonna need to do something that you don't want to do. You might need to bat 300 balls, so you need to bat a whole session without scoring 10 runs. But it might not be something you want to do, but you learn to develop those attributes, and it's a mental thing you have to get past. It's a barrier that you could control. And yeah, definitely something that I looked into, was reading, and it helped a lot. And mentally, I'm in a much better mind space and now than I was probably for the South Africa series, where in training I just wasn't feeling good. I was questioning my technique. I did not feel good in training. Publicly, those are things that people might not come out, but for me, it's all about growing, and it's all about helping you and showing you the difference of that series. And then the Sri Lanka series later in the year, where I was feeling great. Even in the Pakistan series, it's a very good example of the Pakistan series at home. I was feeling great in training. I told Monty, this is the best I've felt in a long time. And then coming into that, those games, I was feeling exceptional in the middle when I was batting, but the runs just weren't coming. I was being frustrated because I was batting well, I was middling the ball, I was playing good shots, but I might find a fielder, then I might get a good ball, or the one mistake I make and it's all over. But for me, to get past that obstacle was more knowing that everything happens for a reason. Maybe it might not happen at this time, but it'll happen again. But that doesn't mean you're not putting in the hard work. You still have to put in the work for those rewards to come. Sometimes you'll be putting all the hard work, but the rewards don't come. But it's just not ready yet. Those rewards are still coming, but it might just take a little longer to happen. Coming into that Sri Lanka series again, it just transferred over. I felt amazing. I was feeling good. In the best v best before that, I was feeling good, but I wasn't scoring runs. But yeah, it's just about me sharing those experiences with you. I want everyone to grow from this. This is what I made this YouTube channel for, is to show my experiences as an international cricketer for the next generation. For me, those are the key things. It's about knowing that putting in the work, it might not come, but you may fail, or you will fail more than you succeed in this game of cricket. It's brutal, as I said. It's an unforgiving game, but you love it. And there's a reason you play it. It's because for the love, for the passion, and just remember those three things and continue working hard. I'm thinking about doing my goals for 2022. That could probably help you a lot in showing you how you can go about your goals, hoping you have cricket where you are. Let's see if you can tell me your goals down below, and then I'll make a video of my goals. I appreciate it for watching. If you've made it this far, press that like button, subscribe, it helps us out. Let's get to 14k, I believe it is, or we can get up to 15 as quick as possible. But yeah, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.